And that's a smoky quartz, by the way, the sphere. Because I kind of want to use these as teaching moments too, because you know you can do a lot of this yourself. And the smoky quartz helps clear everything, and then the fluoride is a healer too, and that always helps, you know, on the chakras energetically.
Now, do you have to have balls? Because I have all of these, I just don't have them in spheres.
No, it's just much easier for what I'm doing here.
To roll them,
yeah. But you can use, yeah, anything. And then you want to cleanse them.
With the smoke.
Smoke or salt water or... Some people, you know, put them in the...
Moon
and stuff. Yeah. I still would put them in salt water, though. Again, there's science there. I tell you what, one thing I'm getting here, it's like you said, everything's so neutral. It's not one or the other. If there's something going on here, we're going to work on that, and that makes sense. But everything else is kind of like just so...
Indifferent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have here medicine pouches that I made for each chakra, and the difference between these and maybe most other things is it's not just the chakras we're working on, but the connections in between, so that we'll work on the entire system, the chakra network, which also includes meridians and the etheric bodies, the energy bodies. Mm-hmm. I don't know anything about the meridians, but I know that they're part of this, and so we're going to, that plays into everything. feels like, okay, like you say, around 12, you know, 13, the age 13 is like the spiritual maturity date. You know, you see that in confirmation and bar mitzvahs and things like that. And so there's, this is right before that big breaking point, but it's like there's a sense of just being completely alone. Mom, dad, where were they?
His mom was working a lot and, you know, doing whatever. And then his dad, he never knew who his real dad was. Yeah. Until he turned 19, and then his mom told him.
So, I mean, it's like completely alone and abandoned feelings back then, and that was a critical point for the development and things. So he had no direction, he had no guidance, he had no support, and that's where a lot of this looking and at the same time was a seeking even back then for a bigger purpose. So it's kind of. Sad. Mm-hmm. And he was sad. The alcoholism, the addictions, looking to fill that void. I mean, that was the numbing. It kind of numbed the pain and things like, I mean, that's where it all started. The depression, just not feeling. And then from that came this sense of having to be the strong one and the one to do it all and to be, you know, the pillar and the strength and the go-to guy and the manly man that he, I'm guessing, work like hell, rest when you're done, all that, very macho stuff, which is, that's fine, but just understand that you don't have to bust your ass all the time. The Nordic thing of strong, I mean, it's, I think there's a past life there. Oh, it's yeah, the old past, it's a past life. I mean, this is very, the whole demeanor, the indifference is kind of, the word protection, dealing with, it's not an avoidance strategy, but it is a coping way of coping and protecting, not expecting to, not relying too much, or, you know, on anyone, or believing too much in anything, disappointment if you do, belief in self. The Vikings and all that, very independent, very strong will, I think, so that resonates with him. But so lost, if you will, we could talk about what that means. 12 and before, a couple of deaths. And energetically, it feels like he's just taking on too much. I don't know what he's taking on. He's taking on too much. And that kind of broke. Some things kind of broke. Is there? of a conflict. There's a really strong spiritual pull, but there's also that very manly thing that gets in the way. He's having a hard time reconciling the two, and that's what we're getting from the past, because he feels he has to be strong. And so I guess on some level, things, the spiritual thing is a little on the weak side. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Kind of unmanly or okay. So I don't know how, but that can be reconciled, because you got to be strong to do this. You got to be. So that's the thing. I just really don't get anything on schizophrenia, though. I mean, I get confusion. I get, yeah, there may be even some things, and I can give you a prayer to, like, get any attachments off, if there are, okay? But it's just that macho, indifferent, it's kind of getting in the way of the spiritual thing that his soul's reaching for, though. And I don't mean to talk about you. It's just, I know you're going to be the spokesperson, right? Okay. Yes, okay. So. We're going to gather up pieces from way back. Remind me to tell you about the past life.
Do what?
Remind me about the past life, his past life. If I can, the Nordic thing. Okay, I'll just, very vivid, very strong, and no real details other than it was just a harsh, desolate, you can imagine back then how that was. Fight for everything you had to have, and I think a lot of that's vibing like right now, the past life thing, and the resonance with the belief system as well. of the inner child was damaged, was gone. But that came, some of that came back too. So you know, the playfulness, the trust, the things like that. That might be a little hard to come back around, but it can. It's there again. How you feel?
I'm good.
Watch your eyes. Don't be bright.